Hi, and welcome to this very first Northmyth video. We're very excited about that. Today's topic is how to cast runes. And this is my little fella here. You see that? So the first runic alphabet is actually around 2,000 years old, which is a lot older than the Vikings that they're normally associated with. And they are also a huge part of the Norse god Odin's magical toolbox. These little symbols were used in the North European Iron Age to cast magical spells or to see into one's future. Full disclosure, from a historical point of view, we actually don't know a lot about the ritual behind the rune casting, but we do have this Roman historian Tacitus. Tacitus described a ritual practice where the Germanic tribes would cast and then interpret symbols. So that's what we're going to try to do today, and let's just go somewhere a little more heathen than my living room. Let's go.
So here I am, out in the woods. We are going to pray a little prayer to Odin and ask the runes if our Northmyth project is going to be a success. And I'm going to shake the back and draw some random runes. Let's see. Oh, I got Urus. Urus is the wild ox. And that's a good symbol. That's passion and power and a little bit of chaos. Which I am taking to mean that we are going to need those powers in Northmyth if we are going to be successful. And the second rune is Tivas, which it does mean victory, so that's really good. Wow, that's great. Victory, Tivas victory comes with sacrifice, so maybe that's the passion and the hard work, the power we're going to have to put into this project. It represents this sacrifice, the challenges that we're going to face with Northmyth. The last rune is Algis. Algis is a protection rune often of something you love. And I am guessing that in this climb towards success with our Northmyth site, we are going to have to remember to look after each other in the face of great challenges. We should remember to care for each other. So that's a pretty good sign. I'm really happy with this casting. It bodes well for Northmyth.
In order to cast runes yourself, you obviously need to have a set of runes. You can make them yourself. There are some great tutorials online, and I will link to one in the description below. I made one myself, just taking a branch and cutting them into pieces and writing these symbols. You can also buy a pair. There are some really beautiful ones online. I'm using the Elderfutak alphabet because it is the one mostly, it's the oldest one, and it is the one that is most often associated with magic. Lastly, you do need to know what the different symbols mean or are associated with, and there are some awesome sites online. I will link to one of my favorites in the description below, where you can go and explore the meaning of the runes yourself. We're not going to cover it here because that is way too extensive for this video. If you are a lazy cat, you can go to northmyth.com. We have a free rune casting game where you can go in and have your future told by the runes. So that's it for now, you guys. Enjoy diving into the exciting, mystical, magical world of rune casting. And I hope to see you soon when Northmyth will return with more entertainment on Norse mythology. Bye!